to read a scripture in the book of Psalms 27 and verse 1. That will be our principal scripture we are going to read so that we can continue with our service. So our scripture will come from Psalms 27, and we're going to read the verse 1. Esther, you can read for us that verse, and after that we will continue. Psalms 27, and we're going to read verse 1.
The Lord is my light and my salvation, so why should I be afraid? The Lord is my fortress, protecting me from danger, so why should I tremble? Amen.
Yes. So that's the place we are reading today for our youth session. And it comes from the book of Psalms 27, verse 1. Who wrote the book of Psalms? Can somebody remind me also? David. Who's the writer of the book of Psalms?
David.
David, yes. Thank you very much. So today we are going to talk about fear. We are going to talk about fear. We always fear for some reasons. I don't know why, but it's happened that every human being can fear. And that depending on several reasons that which can come in front of us. So that's why we're going to talk about fear, because it's something which can happen to anybody as a human being. And when we are reading from the book of Psalms, chapter 27, verse 1, we'll be going slowly. I will read also in my Bible, and the book of Psalms 27, verse 1. Yes. Yes, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? That is what we read from the book of Psalms, from this verse 1. And the Bible is saying that the Lord is my light. The Lord is your light. The Lord is our light. Who shall we fear? That's the question. If you and me, we know that the Lord is our light, who shall we fear? I don't know what kind of fears you have. I don't know what kind of fear I have myself at this moment. But the Bible is asking a question. If the Lord is your light, as you are here today, if the Lord is my light, as I'm standing here today, whom shall I fear here on this earth? But this happened several times in our life that we find ourselves that we are in a state of fearing. We fear so many things surrounding us. We fear maybe our future. We fear maybe what will be our tomorrow. These are things that will happen every time in our life as human beings. But the question in this book of Psalms, David is encouraging you and me, but there's a question there. Whom shall I fear? Because you know that the Lord is your light. Because I know that the Lord is my light. What does it mean, fear? What's the meaning of fear? Can somebody tell me what is the meaning of fear? Esther, do you have any idea? What for you can be the meaning of fear?
Like being scared of something?
Yeah. For example?
Like scared of a cat or something like that.
Scared of something, okay. Yes. So you see that we can have so many different kinds of fear. But understand that fear is not a positive, emotion. It's always a negative emotions. We have positive emotions, and we have what we call negative emotions. But fear will just fall under what we call negative emotions. Because when we are in a state of fear, we are not really comfortable. We don't feel better with ourselves. We feel that there's something which is missing with us. We are not connecting with our body, with our soul, with our mind, because of the fear we have within ourselves. It means directly fear. It is only what, it's a negative emotion toward human being. It's something which can be an instant. Instant is something that comes naturally. You are not forcing it. It's happened only, it comes. Fear can come in that way. Fear also can be something that maybe you learned. You learned in your family. People, they told about certain things that can bring fear to you. And you understand when you are in front of those things, it makes you to feel that you are in a state of fear. It can be also something maybe you are being taught by other people. So you see that fear can be displayed in different ways. And we cannot avoid fear, because it's something which will come every time in our life. But the Bible is saying, the Lord is your light, the Lord is my light. Whom shall I fear? It is really a question. It continues saying, it's not only your light, but the Lord also, it is your salvation. To whom shall I, fear? He's your light, and apart from being your light, it's also your salvation. When we read here, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Not only your light, but it's also your salvation. In the book of John, chapter 1, verse 4, the Bible is saying, in him was life, and the life was the light of men. In the book of John, in the New Testament. In him, John chapter 4, verse 4, in him was life, and the life was the light of men. In him, in who? In who? In Jesus Christ. In Jesus Christ was life, and the life was the light of man. There was life in Jesus, Christ, and that life was the light of man. It means you cannot have life if you are not living in the light. To have life, you need to live. You need to be in the light so that you can have life. Because Jesus is the light of the world. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The Lord is my light. It means the Lord is my life. If you don't have light in you, there's no life also in you. To have life, you need to shine. You shine in whom? You shine in Jesus Christ. To him, there was what? There was life. And the life was the light of man. He was the light of man. He was our light, Jesus Christ. But the question now came to David. The Lord is my light. Whom shall I fear? If I have life within myself, whom shall I fear? If I have Jesus in my life, whom shall I fear? If you have Jesus, if you have the light of Jesus, whom shall you fear? Because Jesus is within you. It means you should not be afraid when you know that you have Jesus. No matter fear which will come toward you, the Bible says you should not fear, because you have the life by having Jesus Christ within you. The Bible continues saying he is also our salvation. Jesus is your salvation. Jesus is my salvation. He is not only only your light so that you can fear, but he is also your salvation. What does it mean to be your salvation? Jesus to be your salvation, it means that it's your deliverance. It's somebody who delivered you. We were not supposed to be called children of God, but because of his salvation, he came to deliver us from our sins. He came to deliver us from where we were in the pit, and we became really his own children. He is not only your light, but he is your salvation. He is your deliverance. He is your redemption. Jesus is your redemption. Why shall you continue to fear? He is somebody who delivered you. Why shall you continue to fear no matter the situation you are in? For now, what are you fearing? You fear about what? What are your fear in school? What are your fear at home? What are your fears at your area, I don't know, at work? What are your fears? What are the fears you have at this moment? But the word of God is encouraging you to tell you that Jesus is your light and Jesus is also your salvation. Jesus is your change. Jesus is your redemption. Fear not, because he's going to be with you always. No matter situation you are passing through as youth, there are so many challenges you are passing through. But the word of God today is telling you, you should not fear when you know that you have Jesus Christ. Jesus came to redeem you. Jesus came to be your redeemer. He came to be your deliverer. So you need really to hold him with your two hands, because he's there to protect you in every situation you are going to find yourself. To whom shall I fear? To whom shall I be afraid? If I know that Jesus is my light, if I know that Jesus is my salvation, if you know that Jesus is your light, if you know that Jesus is your salvation, what will be your worry? And you know that you have somebody to take care of you. Jesus is your stronghold. The same verse, it says, the Lord is the stronghold of my life, of whom shall I be afraid? He's not only your light, he's not only your salvation, but the Bible says also that it is his, your stronghold. What does it mean, Jesus to be your stronghold? Jesus to be your stronghold means Jesus is your place of refuge. I don't know, when you find yourself in trouble, you want to run, you want to go where? But the Bible says that Jesus is your stronghold. He's your place of refuge. He's your place, he's your place of security. Oh my God. He is there to fortify you when you are down. He's there to take you up. He's there to fortify you. He's there, is your place really of redemption. To be your stronghold is where you can go and get solution to your problems. It's happened that sometimes we feel that we are down, all of us as human beings. Maybe we lost a member of our family. At that time, we are not comfortable. We fear. We lost a parent. We fear. We ask ourselves, what will be our future? What will be our tomorrow? You are in school, you fear about maybe your study. This question will come always. Am I going to succeed? Am I going to pass? Fear will come. Fear will surround us every time. Remember to quote this scripture. Jesus is my light. Jesus is my salvation. Jesus is my stronghold. Hallelujah. Remember to quote those words when you found yourself in the situation of trouble, because it will come. You cannot escape from that. Fear is there, it's a reality, it is there. I'm not saying that you're going to dilute it in the world. It will be there. But the problem, how you handle that fear. How do you deal with the fear you have in your community? How do you deal with the fear you have in your family? How do you deal with the fear you have at school? How do you deal with the fear you have at work? You're working with people of different background. But to go and feel comfortably, comfortable in that place, it's hard. But the Bible says, Jesus is your light. You are going to be light within a certain group of people because of Jesus. People, they are going to welcome you because you live in the light. People, they are going to welcome you because you are in the salvation of Jesus. People, they are going to welcome you because you have a place of refuge whenever you are in a problem. What shall we do now if we find ourselves in the situation of fear? What will be our medicine? What will be our solution to that situation? Without going left and right, our solution is just to trust in the Lord. Hallelujah. We need to trust in the Lord. By considering what is above, Jesus is our light. Jesus is what? Jesus is our salvation. Jesus is our stronghold. It means our solution is to trust in the Lord. That is the only way we can escape all this kind of the situation which will come really to the world. Will come really to trouble our mind, to trouble our life, to trouble our situation every day. We need to trust in the Lord. We need to have faith in what Jesus can do today and in what Jesus can do for you tomorrow. You need to trust in Him. There's nothing else to do. I don't know, maybe you trust in your dad, you trust in your mom, but they are not solution to any kind of the problem you are going to get. We have so many situations. The world is very complicated. And this situation, you cannot handle, you cannot give it to your mom, because your mom also will not be able to handle it. You cannot give it to your dad, because your dad also will not be able to handle it. But the one who will be able to handle it, it's your Father in heaven. He handled the problem of your mom. He handled the problem of your dad. You too, you need to go to Him so that He can handle your problem. Jesus, all of us, is a place of refuge. You are youth, you are old, you are don't know what, you are a manager, you are what. Jesus is, all of us, a place of refuge. I don't know where you go when you found yourself in a problem. You trust in your techniques. You trust in your money, you trust in your parents, you trust in your friend, you trust in what? But remember what we are talking here. Jesus is our place of refuge because He's our stronghold. Jesus is our salvation. Jesus is our deliverer. Jesus is our redemption. When we find ourselves in the situation of fear. Can you eliminate fear? Hello? Can you eliminate fear, considering what we are saying? To eliminate, to remove fear. Can you remove it completely? Hello? Are we together? Is it able to dilute fear? I want to hear from you guys. Can you remove completely fear? Can you remove it completely? Can somebody answer, please? This is like discussing with you. Can we remove or to dilute fear? Destiny, Melody, is it possible to dilute fear? I want to hear from you, please. Destiny is saying that you cannot really remove fear completely because you are living in the world which is very, very complicated. As I said, it's changing every day, and it comes with so many challenges. Is there anybody also to add on top of that? Or somebody who has a different approach, different suggestion? Naomi Mubagwa. Is it possible to remove fear?
No, I'm going to have to agree with Melody.
You agree with Melody?
Yeah.
Okay. Lydia, what do you think?
No, I don't have anything to add.
Huh?
I don't have anything to add.
You agree?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we cannot really remove fear completely. We cannot remove it, as we have said. Now, if we cannot remove fear, what should we do? What should we do now? What will be our approach to deal with fear? Because we are saying that we cannot remove it. You cannot eliminate fear. What will be now our way of dealing with it? Hello? Mm-hmm. If you cannot remove it, what should we do now to deal with it? What should we do? We can decrease a certain percentage of fear, but you cannot remove it. It's 100, maybe you can bring it to, I don't know, to 70% or to 60. And the 40 remaining of fear, how are we going to deal with it? You remove 60, but you remain with 40 you are fearing. How you gonna deal with the 40? Hello, hello. Yes, yes, at the back there, yes.
Pray.
Sorry?
Pray.
Prayer is very important, yes. There's things you cannot deal with yourself. If you don't have a really solution to something, what do? You pray. You are not going to fight with it. Fear will not respond if you fight with it. Will you going to receive an answer? When you fight with fear, are you going to receive an answer? Let me ask you, do you see fear? Can you touch fear? Can you touch it? It's not physical. Hallelujah. So you cannot really fight with it. What can you do? One of the solutions, you can do what you can pray. Thank you very much. What else? What the other solution to do? What other solution? It means you need to have what we call the management. You have to manage fear. You have to manage it, to handle it. Because you cannot remove it. Today it will go away, tomorrow something else comes. Tomorrow it goes away, something comes after tomorrow. So you see, it's not something that really you can remove completely in your life. Those are challenges which will come every day, after 2 days, after 3 days, after a week. But you continue to do it. You continue to call Jesus to be your stronghold. To be your place of refuge. That will be your answer. You pray and you know that Jesus is your place of refuge. It means we have to trust in the Lord. That's the way of the management we can have. Trust in the Lord, pray. Have confidence in the Lord, not in you, in yourself. Have confidence in Jesus. When you have confidence in Jesus, when these problems come, you're going to find yourself that you are going up instead of going down. Not to have confidence in yourself. No, you have confidence in Jesus, so Jesus can help you in every kind of situation you find yourself. It brings you confidence when you trust in the Lord. Not the confidence of the world. I have confidence of myself. I have confidence of... No! You have confidence in the Lord, that the Lord is taking care of your situation. At work, at school, wherever you are, you know you put that God first. Don't put yourself first. Saying that I'm knowledgeable, I'm intelligent, I'm smart, and whatever. No, you are not smart because there is a place where you are going to do it. You are going only to stuck. So whenever you stuck, who shall be? Where are you going to have somebody to help you? You need to go to Jesus so that he can help you. It means you have confidence in Jesus. You trust in Jesus. The people of the world, we use the term confidence. But us, we use normally trust. We trust in the Lord. Can fear dictate your actions? Can fear dictate your actions? I want really to hear from you there. How fear can dictate your actions? Somebody else, fear can dictate your actions. Let me give an example which is really practical. When you are in front of an exam, a paper, and fear comes suddenly, what do you think will be really can be the outcome of that exam? Huh? Sorry? Loudly? Fail. Yeah. The result will be fail. The paper is coming, you have not even read the questions. The 100 questions, oh my gosh. 100 questions, biology. How am I going to really survive with this? You have not even read the question from 1 to it's 100. The teacher is saying it's 100 questions for this course for biology. And when you see, you say, oh my gosh. Am I going really to survive with these 100 questions? Too much. You start fearing. By the time the fear is increasing, that also your confidence also is going. It's going down. It's going low. Do you understand? Your confidence will go low because of what? Because fear is already with you. It means fear can dictate your actions. It means action can be either negative actions or positive actions. If you just take this exam like a normal paper, this is already a good attitude. Before an exam, you see that it's normal, and you take that paper without any problem, you go. And after that, you give the paper. But when you start fearing, that is already a problem. It means fear can change our actions, and those actions can be either positive or negative. So it means we need to know how to handle fear normally when we are in a certain situation. And we are saying that we cannot lay off, we cannot really lay it, you cannot really remove it. It will remain with us. So what is now the consequence